Hello guys, this is Jamie Butler 190 here and welcome to the next in the series. Oh my god, it's been so long in the worldwide Battle of the Coasters Worldwide Edition. I am so sorry it took so long. To be honest, I completely forgot that I started up a new series, so I'm really sorry, I completely forgot. And then someone actually commented not long ago saying, Oh, you got a new series out. I was like, oh yeah. So I'm trying to whittle down of what's actually right on my channel at the moment. So this series definitely runs well. So this series we're starting at the moment. I'm currently rendering a new Parkitect episode. So if you enjoyed the last one, be sure to like this one. I'll start a brand new park in this one where I properly build it up and make it look awesome. So I just wanted to say before I start, if you haven't already, hit the massive subscribe button. It is down there, it's in red. I'm nearly at 2,000. It'd be awesome to hit 2,000 before the end of May, maybe even August. That'd be absolutely brilliant. But anyway, let's get straight into the next in the series of the worldwide edition of Coaster Battle of the Coasters. Now, in case you didn't know, the last coaster won was Shambhala. So well done, Shambhala. You will be working ahead and in the next of this series. That's brilliant. Okay, so let's get straight into it. Okay, so in this episode, it's gonna be a Wild Eagle at Dollywood versus Swarm over at Fort Park. Now, in case you haven't heard about the news about Fort Park's Darren Brown's Ghost Train, go and check out the video before this one, and everything is in there about it being delayed. Okay, so let's get in straight into it, where we start off with Wild Eagle over at Dollywood. So Wild Eagle is obviously at Dollywood. It is in the Wilderness Pass Park section of the theme park. It is currently operating and has since March the 24th, 2012, with a soft opening in March the 21st, 2012, so the day before. This coaster cost $20 million. It is a steel wing coaster manufactured by B&M. It has a chain lift hill with a height of 135 foot, which is about 41 meters, a length of 3,127 feet in total, which is 953 meters, with a maximum speed of 61 miles per hour, which is 98 kilometers per hour. It has a maximum of 4 inversions with a duration of 2 minutes and 22 seconds of ride time. The height restriction on this is between 127 centimeters and 198 centimeters. The trains on this is 2 trains with 7 cars. Riders are arranged in 4 across in a single row for a total of 28 riders per train. So that is Wild Eagle over at Dollywood. Let's get straight into Swarm over at Fort Park. So the Swarm over at Fort Park is currently operating, and it doesn't actually have its own park area, but it has its own little island it's on. You'll know if you actually go over there. It has been operating since the 15th of March 2012. It cost £20 million. It is again a steel wing coaster manufactured by B&M. Designer on this was John Wardley. It is a custom layout. It has a chain lift hill with a height of 39 meters, which is 128 foot, with a length of 775 meters, which is 2,543 foot. The maximum speed on this you'll get is 59 miles per hour, which is 95 kilometers per hour, with 4 inversions, with a duration of 1 minute and 25 seconds of ride time. The capacity on this is 1,300 rides per hour, so pretty lengthy. The G-force you'll hit on this is 4.5G at the bottom of the first drop. The height restriction on this is 140 centimeters or 1.4 meters or 4 foot 7 inches. And the trains on this is 2 trains with 7 cars. Riders are arranged 4 across in a single row for a total of 28 riders per train. The maximum height on this is 196 centimeters due to the near misses. Now, another little information about this, it also used to have its back 2 rows reversed, so you could experience the ride backwards, but in 2016, Fort Park took the decision to change them 2 rows back to normal, so the whole train now faces forwards. Let me know in the comments below if you preferred the backwards facing or now it all forward facing. Anyway, that is for this week's Battle of the Coasters. I will try and get one out each week from now on. Smack me if you see me if I don't. But anyway, like, comment and subscribe. Make sure you vote below. I'll leave a little eye up here as well, but I'll also put it in the description as well. So comment below which coaster you think should win. Hope you enjoyed this episode of Battle of the Coasters. Like, comment and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.